All right, so NHL draft and NBA draft coming your way this week. And we begin with our Lexus Hot Topic, as always, presented by the luxury vehicle of the New York Knicks, Anthony Davis. All right, so the Raptors win the championship, and that seems like yesterday's news very quickly because Anthony Davis has been traded, of course, everyone knows by now, to the Lakers. Pelicans give up a king's ransom, and the deal for David Griffin that he engineered for the Pelicans is pretty good because he gets a number 4 overall pick. Look at all these assets. Brandon Ingram is, remember, coming off the blood clot. The first-round pick that I just mentioned, first-round pick in 2021, first-round pick swap potentially in 2023, and a first-round pick in 2024. And now the Lakers can pair Anthony Davis with LeBron James, and potentially, depending on how things work, they could have room for another max contract. Ladies and gentlemen, what do you have? I mean, this is... I think the timing's a little bit surprising. We kind of heard rumors that, you know, the Pelicans were thinking about doing something, but well in advance of the draft and well in advance of free agency, the Lakers look like the favorite already to win the championship.
They do. They are the favorites now, and they got one more max to fill, but they also got to fill that roster. They're probably going to get some experienced guys. There's no secret that I played with LeBron. He likes to play with experience. He doesn't like young guys. He doesn't like rookies. He doesn't like youth. He likes guys that have been there, that are ready to win. No, that's his motto. That's always been there. And he has a team now that they're probably going to put around him where they're going to have a chance to win a championship. And that's when he raises his game.
Around him, though, I think is still my question mark. Because AD is huge. And yeah. God forbid, if Kawhi ends up as a Laker, I don't know what I'll do. I can't stand it. I mean, that is just the super team ever. But I still think that team, in terms of depth, what are we going to do?
They have five players under contract right now, by the way.
They need to bring depth in. And I think what they'll do is look to fill shooters.
Well,
they've
got
to get shooters around
them.
They need shooters, jump
right?
shooters.
I mean, there you go. You need a shooter.
You got to play some defense, too.
Yeah, they're going to need a little bit. But I think the Pelicans, to your point, got a lot in that. I thought that Griffin did a good job just dickering that whole entire thing because, listen, that's the future. They can build around Zion. I think the Pelicans are going to be pretty good, too. But AD there, man, it changes everything.
Good for the league.
It is. It's great for the league. AD's a guy who's been... You know, he's had a great career, obviously, with the Pelicans, but it's come to a point where he has the option to play in a big market. He wants to go to a big market. He wants to play and have a chance to win a championship. No matter what, he's taken the team to as far as it can go, but they've never had championship aspirations and really championship expectations. Now he gets what he wants, and the Pelicans are going to completely retool right away, like you said.
And I tell you, the Lakers had to do this because LeBron's got 3 years left on the deal, showed his age a bit this year with the injury problems, have to be competitive right away, and this is probably the best way to do it.
I also think, too, there's a window. I mean, Wally, you know, there's a window for guys to win championships. Mm-hmm. AD is in the perfect spot right now. He's still young.
26.
He's 26. Mm-hmm. His
is
prime.
He
wants to win a championship, so who can blame the guy for going to LA and trying to do it with LeBron.
So here's the thing. We all agree that this talent is undeniable.
Mm-hmm.
Are they going to get a title next year? I don't think it happens that quick.
I don't think so.
Are you serious?
Well, wait, why not?
Why not?
Because we even saw when LeBron went to Miami.
Right.
It took a minute. I'm not saying the Warriors would be necessarily the most formidable challenge, but I'm just saying they still will need a year. And like we saw with Toronto or even with Golden State in this finals, the bench matters.
And I'm careful to say anything anymore seeing all the injuries this year. I'm not going to say they're an instant contender. I mean, if they both stay healthy, I mean, LeBron's aging. Look what happened to him. He missed, 20 games, 18 mm-hmm. games? So, I mean, it all depends. Health.
I tell you, it's going to be very interesting. And you know what? It seems like 6 weeks ago
pick to win it
that the Raptors won the championship.
Right now, seriously.
Did you have picked the Raptors?
We're going to
even
pull
though
this
they
up,
haven't
come
assembled
this time
the
next
roster,
year.
You have those two guys to build around. You have another max slot. People are going to want to go play. They're going to
all
be
right, I'm
lined
this
up
down
to play.
Because, well, just as everyone remembers,
really Vogel, like those guys, none of that.
They're a good combination,
It's a lot to mix together. It's a lot to mix. You got three head coaches, two big-time superstars.
But AD is
who
not
else?
As
who's
dominant.
Your pick then?
I don't have one. I just don't know. This is the Lakers right now.
How about Denver?
Put your chips to the middle of the table. Put your poker chips to the middle of the table, ladies.
Wally really liked the Celtics this year, so let's just keep that in mind.
I have the right to be wrong.
Thursday night, it seems like, I don't know, 6 weeks ago, that Raptors won the championship. And it was just Thursday night.
Yep.
And they had the win over the Warriors. Big story, of course, the Warrior injuries. And you wonder, it's a bigger story, the Raptors winning their first ever championship or what's left of the Warriors and the impact that the injuries of KD and Klay Thompson are going to have on this summer. They had the parade in Toronto today. Kawhi Leonard, obviously the finals MVP. They were chanting one more year, Kawhi, and Kyle Lowry jumped in. Five more years. that's going to be an interesting dynamic when free agency rolls around here very soon. But the Raptors, you know, Walt, do you take anything away from what they were able to accomplish given what happened with the Warriors in terms of the injuries?
Absolutely.
No,
not.
You guys don't.
No, because other teams have won championships taking advantage of injuries.
I know, but this is
the name of the game. This
is unprecedented.
Okay, but let's just go back to Kawhi. 3-point shot in front of the bench, ankle, when the Spurs were smacking the Warriors to open up that series. So injuries have played a role in lots of people's narratives.
And staying healthy, that's a skill. And sometimes you have to orchestrate your regular season to make sure you're healthy for the postseason. You know, remember, the Golden State Warriors went through a lot of injuries during the regular season. Steph was out for a while. Klay was out here and there. So KD had to log a lot of minutes. He put a lot of load on his body. And in the end, that kind of wore him down in the playoffs, I think.
And to your point, Wally and Monica, remember what their motto was strength in numbers.
Yeah.
And then they got slim. I think it's all about developing that bench. And
I know, but Jules, you got two transformative players in Durant and Klay Thompson.
It changed everything.
But there's
no
bench that's going to be able to make up for that.
No, I agree. But it happens. Injuries happen. The Klay Thompson was
But he can't take away from Toronto. Yeah. That's the thing. You can't take away from what they did.
I think Magic even tweeted about suffering an injury alongside, who's the coach? Who am I thinking of? That was with the Lakers.
Magic?
That played with Magic. Name is slipping my mind. But anyway, he came up with a lame hamstring and Magic was injured.
Scott?
There we go.
Yeah.
Byron Scott. They both were injured in the series that they were in. So it's definitely a part of the game. I think to put an asterisk on it is to negate just how skilled, one, Kawhi Leonard is, and then how well, outside of the timeout, Nick Nurse coached that team, because you saw guys come out of seemingly nowhere. Yep. Did you know who Fred VanVleet was since Wichita State?
He didn't miss a shot.
He was incredible.
You know what the thing is? Let me ask you. If Klay Thompson comes back the other night, the Warriors win that game?
Yeah, it's game. Yeah. Definitely game seven. I was hoping for a game seven.
And as it is, Steph Curry had a makeable three there down the stretch.
Did they want to go to a game seven?
What if somebody else got hurt? That's my thing.
You always want to go to a game seven. As a fan, I wanted to watch a game seven. This was just an unfortunate injury. See, that's why you hang on the rim in that situation. When I went up with two hands, at times, you're a little bit vulnerable with the landing. If you get fouled, you just hold on to that rim for dear life.
Tough to watch.
Yeah, and then he was paying attention.
He showed it a lot.
And then
he
comes back out to hit the free throws, and then he goes back in. It's
just that guy is an absolute warrior.
Told Steve Kerr, I'll be back in a couple of minutes, and then he went back into the tunnel, and the swelling got to the point.
And he had 30 points at that point.
He was
hot. Mr. Clutch.
He was on the way to like 60 that night.
Yeah, and Alan Hahn said he's Mr. Game 6, and he was actually proving Alan Hahn's useless stats useful for once.
Don't give Alan Hahn any credit.
He was right for once.
If he comes back, though, when they win Game 6, they may have won Game 7.
They could have.
You know?
Definitely could have.
I'm not actually sold that they win Game 6, though, honestly, because if you look at how close that they had been, granted, I'm not taking anything away from Klay's performance, but I think
he had one of those nights.
But every time it seemed like the Warriors were unstoppable, look at how close the games were when the Warriors won. I think it comes down to the wire. I'm not sold that they still win. Is it probably a more competitive? We still got a great game. Maybe it's tighter, but I'm still not sold that they win.
See, I just think you got to give a little asterisk to all this for Toronto.
No.
I know they got it. Not at all.
Injuries happen.
Yep.
It's just Durant, though.
Do you give an asterisk to the Warriors?
In all your years of watching the game, have you ever seen the severity of these injuries to the nature
Never
of the
in
player?
The playoffs. Never
Not
in the
finals.
Like
two
that?
Major injuries that happen in the finals that completely dictate a series? No, but that's what NBA basketball is all about. That's
Did it completely dictate the series? Like, I'm even willing to...
But here's the thing. If they were both healthy, then the Golden State Warriors win in five.
But this was now fair playing ground.
Okay, I will be the first to admit that I had them winning in five, even with KD out, and I was completely wrong. But I am just thoroughly impressed with what Toronto brought to the table. I think there's a world where we all could be kind of wrong on how this thing goes,
they're a very good basketball team. I mean, they won 56 games or whatever it is in the East.
And they got the two regular season wins.
They had home court advantage, which people kind of didn't realize. They were the home court team. When I was like, oh, game one's in Toronto, I was like, that changes things a little bit.
Do you think this changes the landscape with the super team stuff for next season?
No.
Because of what happened here with Durant, with the injuries.
Well, we got to move on, but free agency is turned completely upside down with all this. It's
going to
be crazy. June 30th at 6 o'clock Eastern Time is when it all begins. For more great videos from the MSG 150, check out right there. And remember, our show is on Monday through Thursday, 8 to 10:30 p.m. on MSG Network and MSG Go.